When the US Department of Agriculture decided to design an icon on good nutrition, it considered a variety of shapes, but finally landed on the Food Guide Pyramid in 1992. This was a departure from four food groups: meats, grains, dairies, fruits and vegetables, which guided the people's eating habit from nearly half a century. In 2005, the USD reveals a renovated pyramid shortly after the publication of the 2005 dietary guidelines on which it is based. Like the guidelines, the new pyramid advises people to eat more fruits and vegetables and consume 3 or more servings of low fat and 3 or more ounces of whole grains, and moderate intake of healthful fats such as those found in nuts, avocados and olive oils. There's one more big change. The new Food Guide Pyramid is web-based, allowing users to change it to their individual needs according to height, age, weight, gender and activity level. In 1997, we drank water from faucets, coolers and fountains, and the coffee we sipped was often brewed at home or purchased at about 5 cents or 30 to 35 rupees a cup. Nowadays, we drink water from bottles and don't blink at paying $5 or 300 or more rupees for a cup of coffee. No wonder beverages have become the major source of calories, accounting for 20% of daily intake. Alcohol has made intriguing health inroads in the past 20 years. Throughout 1980s and 1990s, the researchers observed that who take alcohol in moderation, that is one drink daily for women and two for men, have lower rates of health diseases. About one third of US adults, or approximately 33.8%, are obese, and approximately 17%, or 12.5 million of child and adolescents aged 2 to 19 years are obese. You know why? No, right? Because of their daily diet and nutrition. The food choice each day affects you, how you feel today, tomorrow and in the future. I know that you are wondering what the best diet for you to follow is. The diet that suits your body to grow and boost energy is the best diet for you, like the proper quantity of each nutrient. Good nutrition is an important part of leading a healthy lifestyle. It affects you. Your diet can help you maintain your weight and reduce the risk of diseases. I think that each and every one of us should take care of their diet and nutrition. It affects you. It can cause you many diseases. The adult chronic diseases like hypertension and type 2 diabetes are increasingly seen in younger ages, often a result of unhealthy eating habits and increased weight gain. Dietary habits established in childhood often carry into adulthood. So, teaching your children how to eat healthy at a younger age helps them stay healthy throughout their life. Even for people with healthy weight, poor nutrition is a poor diet is associated with major health risks that can cause illness and even death. These include heart diseases, hypertension, high blood pressure, some types of cancers. The link between good nutrition and healthy weight reduces the risk of diseases and overall health is too important to ignore. By taking steps to eating healthy, you are on your way to getting all the nutrients your body needs. As with physical activity, by making small changes in your diet can go a long way, and it's easier than you think. Research has shown that fats improve blood cholesterol levels, either by cutting down levels of low-density lipoprotein, one of the most damaging types of cholesterol, or by boosting high-density lipoprotein, a protective type of cholesterol. Adding fats to your body is still best tempered with caution. At 9 calories per gram, it contains more than twice the number of calories in carbohydrates or proteins. Some types of fats are still to be avoided. The advice that hasn't changed from past 20 years and isn't likely to change in the future. Poor nutrition includes under or overeating, not having enough healthy food your body needs, or consuming too many types of foods or drinks which are low in fiber, high in fat, salt and sugar. These unhealthy eating habits can affect our nutrition intake. It can contribute to the risk of developing some illness and other health problems, such as being overweight or obese, tooth decay, high blood pressure, some cancers, eating disorders, and many more. I want to end up this talk here by a quote that is, "The only time to eat that food is while you are waiting for the steak to cook," by Julia Child. This means that there is no need of eating that food for being healthy. You can eat whatever you want, but in a proper way. Now that you know everything, it's time for you to start eating healthy. Thank you.